just get to applying. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. My mama used to tell me that about boys. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alexia Nicole, and I am living my life by design. So as you can tell by the title of this video, this is the last part of my four-part How to Become a Flight Attendant interview process. So we are going to be talking about the face-to-face flight attendant interview. It's the final step right before you get that on-the-spot CJO or that email in the next few days that say, thank you, we loved you, we want to invite you to come to our flight attendant training. That's what we've been working towards, y'all, and we're finally here. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. So just a quick disclaimer, I don't want you all to think that I'm dressed currently right now how I would dress for a face-to-face interview. I definitely would not wear this dress. The neckline is just definitely too low, but I'm not home in Houston, Texas. I don't really have a lot of clothes here in New York, so this is what we're rocking with today. And I just left church. You know what? Let's just talk about appearance really quickly. I feel like I really went in depth about appearance in the how to successfully pass the video interview video that I did last week, but I'll talk about it again just in case you all have not seen that video. Basically, you want to look as professional as possible, suited and booted, okay? So let's talk face for the ladies. We want to keep our makeup minimal. You can have your popping red lip like I gave you all today, but you just really want to have a very natural face if you're going to wear makeup. If you're not a really big makeup fan, a little mascara, a little blush, and a nice lipstick or a lip gloss can definitely take you a long way. Hair, we want to keep it pulled back out of your face. If you have bangs, just make sure they're not too long, covering your eyes. You want them to see your pretty face and your pretty smile. The same goes for my guys. A fresh haircut will be nice, and a nice edge up or whatever it is that you do. If you have long hair as a gentleman, go ahead and pull that back as well into a lower ponytail for the ladies as well. For my ladies with natural hair, big natural hair, you are more than welcome to wear your big natural hair if you want to. Just make sure that the length of your hair is not touching your shoulders. As long as it's not touching your shoulders, you should be good and not covering your face, right? So that's all I'm really going to talk about for the hair. Jewelry, we're going to keep it simple, just one small stud earring, nothing bigger than like the size of a dime as far as the stud goes. I don't recommend wearing any type of hoops. Now if it's like one of those really small earrings that kind of cling to the ear that go back and forth, then you can do something like that, but you don't want anything dangling from your ears. One strand of pearls will be good. If you have a necklace with a pendant that sits a little lower, that's okay too, but just make sure that it's not anything too huge that's going to distract them from listening to what you have to say and looking at your pretty smile, okay? You don't want eyes looking here and looking at your hair and all of that. You just want them to be focused on you. Okay, let's talk wardrobe for your face-to-face interview. Guys, you don't really have a ton of options. You're going to get a nice dress shirt. You're going to pair it with a tie that you feel is appropriate for that face-to-face interview, whether you want that tie to match that company's colors or whatever just suits your complexion best. Go for it. If you're going to do, not even if you're going to, okay? For the face-to-face interview, you are going to wear a suit jacket. You gentlemen are going to wear a suit jacket to your face-to-face interview. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. All right, cool. Belt, nice dress slacks, nice dress shoes with socks. So just like I've recommended for the ladies, I probably wouldn't do anything with too much prints or anything like that. A solid neutral colored dress shirt will take you a far way. And then if you want to bring a pop of color with your tie, then go ahead and do so. That's what I recommend for the gentlemen. I know a little thing about style, y'all. I might not always look like it in my videos, but I do because I'm always wearing black, but black's my favorite color. But anyways, That's a story for another day. Ladies, now, we have a lot of options. Like I told you all before, I wanted to show my personality through my wardrobe. So I did wear, you know, things that weren't the classic black and white. And nothing is wrong with the classic black and white. It's beautiful, it's appropriate, it looks great, it's very sharp and clean if you do it correctly. But you can also throw in some color into your outfits. So like I've recommended prior, a nice chic dress will do. Nothing short sleeve. We're either going to want it to be like a cap sleeve or a long sleeve, or if it is going to be sleeveless short sleeve, you're going to want to put a blazer over that. You don't want anything with too much cleavage, ladies. We're going to want to bring this up to here like this. Okay, all right. If you have any tattoos, so I know in my videos, you all probably see my tattoos. You're not going to show any tattoos at any airline interview, okay? It's not appropriate. It's just simply not appropriate for that industry. They're old school in that way. It has not changed, and I honestly don't see it changing anytime soon. So my airline that I work for that's very near and dear to my heart, they actually allow tattoos, but they do have to be covered when you are in the work environment, when you are representing that company. So anytime that you are in uniform or in the building and you're an employee of my airline, your tattoos do have to be covered. Now, there are plenty of other airlines that don't allow tattoos at all. So I'm not saying that to make you think that you shouldn't just go forward with the interview, because heck, whatever, just go for it. But just make sure that whatever tattoos you do have are covered up, and make sure whatever uniforms that that company provides you or is available to you can cover up your tattoos. Now, if you have tattoos on your fingers and behind your ears and all of that, pull a magic trick out the hat, baby, and make it work. Get some makeup and cover that tattoo up. Whatever it takes, just please make sure it's covered. End of story. But for the ladies, so we talked about the sheath dresses, and you can also wear a nice pantsuit as well. I think a pantsuit and a woman that can rock a pantsuit correctly is beautiful. So if that's what you're going to go for, I say do that. Just make sure that we keep the full suit a neutral color. Black, gray, navy. I wouldn't even say a full tan suit. I think that's pushing it a little bit, but you can do it. If you can do it right, then go ahead and do it. I'm not going to knock it, but definitely black, gray, or like a navy blue or something like that, and a nice dress shirt underneath that to complement it will look really well. If you're gonna do a skirt and a top, make sure that your skirt is going to be an appropriate length, which is going to be no more than 2 inches above your knees. Yes, I'm taking y'all back to elementary, middle school, where they would say put your hands beside your legs. Ladies, let me measure the length of your skirt. If that skirt does not pass the tip of your middle finger or whatever your longest finger is, then that's skirt is too short, okay? So if you're gonna wear a skirt, let's just make sure that it's not too tight. If it has a split in the back, make sure it's not riding up your, I think y'all know what I mean. And then you also want to make sure that you have on hosiery with your skirt. If your legs are gonna be out with your skirt or a dress, if your legs are going to be out and exposed, put on some stockings, put on some tights that are going to be flesh colored or black, okay? And even if you say, oh, I don't wear those, I'm not comfortable in them, it's time to get comfortable in them, because that is a part of dress code for every single airline that I know of. So when I wear my pants at work, I have to make sure that I still either have on a sock or tights or hosiery underneath it. There's just no bare skin on the legs can be shown. That's just the rules and regulations. So if you're wearing a skirt, if you're wearing a dress, just please make sure that you have on the appropriate hosiery underneath, okay? Length of the dresses is going to be the same as the skirts as well, ladies. Let's just make sure that that split, I mean, and I'm mentioning this split simply because I've been to interviews and I've seen splits just come a little too high right underneath your rear area, and you just don't want to bend over and everybody see what you're working with. It's not professional, nor is it cute. Then let me talk about my nails, since I actually have an appropriate nail color this week. So my nails are just a natural nudie, like pink color. Some people think it's a big deal, some people don't, but I'm just gonna say, just head to toe, just do it up. Just give them the vision that you already work there and they can see you in their uniform. So your nails need to be a natural color, or a red, or the classic red, or a French tip, or a natural nude like this, or maybe even something a little more, with a little more tan, but keep the diamonds and the greens and the yellows and the purples. Keep those away for a little while we're doing the interview process. Keep the shape of your nails classic, round, square, no stiletto nails, none of that stuff, okay? Let's be professional, let's look the part. Go ahead and insert some photos of what I wore to my face-to-face interview. Some of them will be full body shots, and then some of them will just probably be a selfie so you can see, you know, how my face looked and things like that as far as makeup wise. So this is the day that I went to my American Airlines face-to-face. That was my makeup. This is the outfit that I wore. That's not the day of, but that's the same outfit. This is the day that I went to the Sky West open house interview. And then this is the day that I earned my CJO with the airline that's very near and dear to my heart. I loved that outfit and I got so many compliments. So let's go ahead and talk about what you will actually be doing at your face-to-face interview. So I don't want you to think that I'm just going to go ahead and spill all the beans and give you all the tea on everything that you do, because that's just not fair and it's not fun for you. You know, you want to go in and be excited. And then trust me, if you already know everything ahead of time, you're going to be anxious and nervous and overthinking things, and that's not what I'm setting you all up for. I want to set you all up for success here. So what I will tell you is that at most face-to-face interviews, especially ones that I have been to, except for one of them, I went to a SkyWest interview. I actually received a CJO with SkyWest. SkyWest is a regional airline. They fly for Alaska Airlines, United Airlines, Delta Airlines, and American. So they fly for everybody as a regional carrier. When I went to that interview, they were the only interview that I had been to at a face-to-face type deal where they did not do a group activity. But for any other face-to-face interview for pretty much any other airline, you're going to be doing a group activity or some sort of group interaction where recruiters are going to be watching you and seeing how you interact with the other people in your group. So it might be a situation where you go in and they tell you, okay, sit at this table and there's 6 to 7 people at a table, or you can go in and it's just rows of chairs lined up and you sit. But you definitely want to make sure that when you go in there, you're talking to other people. Don't sit there in a corner to yourself being shy and looking cute. You need to make sure that you're interacting, because one, remember, as a flight attendant, you're going to need to be able to interact with people every day. People that you may not like, people that you probably will never in life see again, but they need to make sure that you have that natural ability to make a connection with someone. It's very important. Recruiters will be watching you, and they might be taking notes in broad daylight, or they may not be, but trust me, they're keeping it in their head to see how you are acting. So just put yourself out there, be jovial with people, etc., etc., etc. You may do a group interview as well. Just be the group of you, how many ever, 5 to 10 people. I guess it just depends on how many people are at the actual interview. I don't know, but it's going to be a group of people, maybe about 1 to 2 to 3 recruiters, and then they're going to be asking questions, and you all are going to be answering them. So of course you'll be able to hear the other candidates' answers because you all will be in a room together answering these questions. Sometimes they give everybody an opportunity to answer the one question, or everybody will have different questions, or whatever the case may be. Sometimes they will say, okay, I will let you all choose who's going to answer what, or sometimes they will call on you name by name. All of these things are just to see how you are going to react and what you do in situations when working with other people. Very important, y'all. So just a reminder, as a flight attendant, it is a very independent job, kinda, sorta. So it's not like your regular 9-to-5 job where you probably have administration or managers, you know, very close to you where they can see every move that you're doing, or retail or anything like that, that you have direct somebody that you can report to every minute of the day. Being a flight attendant, it's not like that. There can be times where you are the only flight attendant on the plane, up to how many ever people that that plane requires. So just so you know, FAA regulations state that for every 50 seats on the plane, there has to be a minimum of one flight attendant. So if that aircraft seats 50 people, then there's going to be one flight attendant. If it seats 51 people, there needs to be two flight attendants on that plane. So just depending on the airline that you work for, what type of aircrafts that they fly, that'll determine how many flight attendants will be on the plane. So there may be times where you have to act independently as the only person on that aircraft. You report to yourself. You do everything by yourself. So they need to be able to see that you can handle that. And they also need to see that you can work as a team. It's very important. In those galleys, I've showed you the galleys in the planes before. They're small. Okay, there's no space to hide and run from your crew member. So if you're not getting along with somebody, you better learn how to fake it and make it. Okay, if you don't like that person, just remember, hopefully that trip is no more than 4 days. It's just 4 days you're spending with that person or less. But you need to be able to be professional enough to handle yourself in a well-behaved manner with somebody that might not be your friend. Okay, so that is also things that they're looking for in these group participant activities and interviews and things like that. I'm gonna give you this key as well. So during these group activities, if it is something where they're watching you all and you all have to interact together in whatever activity it is, make sure that you're speaking up. Make sure that you are giving your opinion on whatever it is that you're doing. Don't sit back and let everybody else do everything. That's not okay. If your personality isn't like the leader type to take charge and do things, I'm gonna need you to step that up just for the day. And you don't necessarily have to lead the charge of everything, but you do need to make sure that your voice is being heard. It's very important. These recruiters are looking for that, okay? Every interview kind of does it differently. Some of them do everything and then have everybody go home at once. Some interviews, they do it step by step and just move people forward throughout the day and send others home. So it just really depends on what airline you're interviewing with and what their process is, but you just need to be prepared for all of it. So when you do have the opportunity to do a one-on-one interview, we're going to make sure that we've practiced all our questions that we found on Glassdoor and on Indeed. Very important. We're going to have star method down. We're going to shake those nerves. And you know what? I say shake those nerves, but it is okay to be a smidget nervous. Most of these people that are doing these interviews have been in your position. They definitely have, so they know what it's like. It's only natural to be a little nervous when you want something so bad, but just don't let your nerves outshadow how great you're going to be for that position. I don't really know how to tell you how not to do that, but just be confident. Like, let that confidence shine right through you, so that whole room, when you walk through the door, everybody gonna turn their head and say, who is that girl? We want her working for our airline. Or who is that gentleman? We want him working for our airline. For your one-on-one interviews, we just wanna make sure that we're poised, we're confident, we're speaking well. Speak slowly, tell stories, make your interviewers laugh. You know, if they are feeling comfortable and relaxed and you can get them to smile and giggle a little bit, it will ease you so much, y'all. Trust me. Like, that was always my goal, to make them smile. And they're going to give you that serious face. And trust me, they're not that serious. Warm them up to you and it will make your interview process so much easier. Just, you want to be able to have natural conversations with the interviewer. For the face-to-face, you want to make sure that you have some really good questions to ask the recruiters. Don't ask them the basics. You know, don't come up with questions like, how long is reserve going to be, and how much am I going to get paid, and all of that. Because believe me and you, they are going to go through all of that in the beginning of the interview process. So when everybody gets there, usually the first 30 minutes to an hour is about what the company has to offer you, what the flight attendant life is going to be like, and blase, blase, blase. So make sure you bring a notepad. If all those details are very important to you, bring a notepad so you can jot all of that down. You want to know how much you're getting paid. I know you want to know how long you're going to be on reserve and what bases they have and all of that. So those aren't going to be the questions that you're going to ask, because they're already going to give you that information. So you need to have more detailed questions. One of my favorite questions to ask the interviewers is, what one thing surprised you most about the company? Because, you know, we all go into it doing all this research and thinking we know everything about the company. And then once you get there, trust me, there's going to be so much that you did not know. So that is something that I always ask the recruiters, just to get real inside of what the company is like. So, you know, what surprises you most about working for this company? And they may give you something positive, they may give you something negative, but at least it's a question that, trust me, they probably don't get all the time. Just be prepared. They're gonna ask you that tell me about yourself question. They're gonna ask you, why do you wanna work for this airline? And have answers to those questions. I'm going to say, don't come up with that answer in the moment off the top of your dome. You need to have an answer prepared and ready, and it needs to come out naturally. I've been telling y'all this since we did the first How to Become an Interview Process video. Just be prepared, y'all. Oh, okay. I guess I can talk about when you'll receive your CJO. And there's no consistent with that either, honestly. With the airline that's very near and dear to my heart, people don't leave with their CJOs the day of. CJO is going to be a conditional job offer, contingent job offer, whatever you want to refer to it as. Basically, it's your invite to training, which is it's the best feeling in the world. So the airline that's near and dear to my heart, they do not offer you a CJO the day of the face-to-face interview. You're going to have to wait a few days to a week or two, just depending on what phase they're going through of the hiring process. You'll receive an email and you'll be happy. For some other airlines, they do offer CJOs on the spot. There are airlines that I know they weed people out throughout the day, and if you make it to that final step, you know, I believe most of the time they will offer you a CJO on the spot, or you'll just receive an email, you know, later with a CJO option, or TBNT. TBNT standing for thanks but no thanks. You won't receive that official thanks but no thanks that day. It's always going to come later in the email. They're probably going to exit you out and tell you, okay, the interview process was great, we'll be in contact with our decision in a week to 2 weeks. That doesn't always mean it's a no. I don't want you all to think that, like, because that is not always a no. You can be surprised with a CJO email later. But what I'm simply saying is, if you don't get the job, you're more than likely not going to officially know the day of. So just be prepared, just be positive, make sure that you're smiling. You want to give them a nice, bright smile that's going to light up their days, and they're going to say, oh my gosh, that smile is so great. I want them to be the person standing at the boarding door when our customers are getting on our plane, so they can bright up their day like they just brightened up mine. But yeah, just go in there with positive thoughts, y'all, saying that this is the airline for me. I'm going to get this job, and you're going to nail that job. And just by any chance that if you do not nail that job, we're going to keep pushing forward, because there's an airline out there for you. And I mean that with my whole heart. I had been applying to airlines. Some of you all may know this if you've watched previous videos of mine, but I had been applying to airlines on a yearly basis since like 2010. Okay, not that in 2010 I was really giving it my all and doing all the research that I needed to do, but I was applying. I wanted a job, but I wasn't all the way prepared and where I needed to be in life. That's just how I took it. So as y'all can see, not even almost 7 years later, after applying year and year and year and year again, I finally made it because I put forth the effort. When you put in the effort, you're gonna receive the blessings. And that's just what I believe. So I will be praying for you all, rooting you on. If y'all have any questions, please feel free to go ahead and comment down below. If you want me to see your outfit, you can send that picture to me as well. Instagram is AlexiaNicole.Life. I forgot for a second. I'll put that down below. I'm definitely here to help. Sometimes it takes me a little while to get back to y'all, and I do apologize about that. I get a little busy sometimes, y'all. Sometimes they give me these long days of flying, and I can't catch up, and then I need 24 hours of sleep to recoup. But I'm here to help in whatever way that I can. Best of luck to you all. We have a few more days until an airline that is near and dear to my heart opens up their application process. Just get to applying. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. My mama used to tell me that about boys, and I have used that in every other aspect of life as well. You know, there may be one thing that you're focused on, but you want to make sure that you're not limiting to yourself to just that one thing or that one man or whatever the case may be. But best of luck. Prayers to you all. I can't wait to see those comments and those emails about you getting your CJOs and going to flight attendant training. I know y'all can do it. So please make sure that you are subscribed. Please make sure that you like this video. Make sure that you share with any other flight attendant hopefuls or whoever you know that this video can be of help to. Love you all. Talk to you later. Bye. So this is the day that I received my CJO email. I was on base. My cousin was getting promoted to captain, and I received the email right in the middle of the ceremony, and I dropped to my knees and I screamed and started crying tears of joy, and he just ran over to me like a best little cousin should.